Everybody's welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly readings for all zodiac signs. I do want to apologize. I know we are a bit behind. There's just been a lot of things going on my personal life as well as career. Extremely busy. I will be doing a video updating you guys on new things that are coming that I will be offering. Anyways, let's get into your reading, Libra. This is going to be Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for the month of August 2021. How are you doing, Libra? I hope you guys are doing amazing. Now, your first card here is the Seven of Cups. This is about choices, Libra. I feel that the remaining of the month of August is going to be, there's going to be a need for you to really focus or try to focus. This is about being cautious not to scatter your energy, not to be doing too many things of something. They are asking you that there's a need for you to focus, to really put your energy and focus towards a specific goal or something that you've been working on, versus being distracted or being pulled towards different directions. So more than anything, I am hearing distractions. So for this month, it's going to be very crucial and important to maintain that focus. Now, your next card here is the Two of Cups. So the Two of Cups could indicate for some of you guys options in regards to love. It could, you know, have to do with deciding, making a choice in regards to a connection. This isn't your obstacle position. So this is indicating to me that you are choosing, in a way, choosing to distract yourself from a specific connection, a specific person, someone that you have feelings for or that you are interested in. Perhaps you've been avoiding something. There is some type of avoidance that's going on here, and it could be the reason why you're keeping yourself, again, distracted is what I'm hearing. So for some of you guys, this is about not wanting to acknowledge or not wanting to face or deal with some type of emotions here that are going on for you. Now, your past and passing is the Knight of Wands. So there was an impulse, something that you were going towards, some type of quick action. This could have been communication. This could have been making a very quick action decision without much thought behind it. Now, your next card here is the Seven of Swords. So sneaky energy here. Let me pull out more cards, see exactly what's going on. Okay, I see it. All right, so, wow, okay. Very interesting here, Libra. So what they're talking about, you've potentially have created some type of distraction from a connection that you felt very strongly towards someone, an individual, someone that is around you, someone that sparked your interest, or perhaps someone that there's feelings there, but it's almost like you are purposely distracting yourself or choosing to distract yourself to kind of avoid a certain type of conversation, open-hearted conversation, things that we need to address about not being very straightforward or not being completely honest. And this could even be not being honest with yourself, Libra. Now, I do see here the need to make a choice. And I feel very heavily for the majority of you. It could be between deciding, not necessarily two people, but you could potentially be involved in a situation where you have multiple options. But I feel that the message that's coming through here is almost like not wanting to acknowledge or not wanting to deal with certain emotions, or not wanting to deal with the true and authentic feelings that you have for someone. And it's almost like with the Seven of Swords, it's giving me the energy of you not being honest with yourself. However, the Lovers here with the Sun card, this is a connection that goes beyond even your understanding, Libra. This is speaking directly about fate. This is speaking directly about destiny. We have major cards here, the Two of Cups, the Lovers, the Sun. This is a soul type of connection with the Ace of Cups here and Temperance, timing. So you could have met a person, you could be dealing with someone where timing was off. Other people could have been involved in this situation that kind of pushed you both towards different directions. However, there's going to be an unfolding event here. I do see the connection, physical connection. This could be bumping into the person. This could be hearing about them through other people. And it's almost like whatever you felt that didn't really start off or didn't move forward is going to be picking up again. And this is definitely not just now in August, but I feel that it's going to unfold all the way to September. The Ace of Cups with the Tower card here, this is understanding or acknowledging or getting to the point of your consciousness being aware, or subconscious, I should say, being aware that there is, that destiny is at play right now. So my advice to you guys is if you're dealing with this type of situation where you feel like there's a very strong pull towards someone and it just seems like you both went towards different directions, trust in the process. There is a lot of, and you may be dealing with a Sagittarius, you may be dealing with a Capricorn, with a Leo, with a Gemini, with a Scorpio. But these are just energies here that we're talking about. And with the Ace of Cups and the Tower, something is going to shake you. This unfolding event, and they're telling me there is going to be some type of communication that happens. But it's almost like you both are being pushed towards each other. That's how they're showing me. So for some of you guys, this could potentially be going somewhere thinking that you're going, you know, to run some errands or whatnot, and you bump into them or you see them, or it's almost like the universe is conspiring to bring you guys two together. And this is definitely going to open up a lot. I feel that both of you guys, both of you that are, for those of you guys that are dealing with this situation, I feel that both of you guys are going to be having this awakening. And I say awakening because they are telling me that but you can be spiritual, or the person that you're interested in could be spiritual. But I feel that one or the other wasn't as aware, because see, we have the Ace of Cups here with the Tower. So this is the understanding, the aha moment, this is not coincidence. So again, you know, the Tower always represents our crown chakra. So this is news that's coming to you, or an understanding that this was not a coincidence. There is a reason and a purpose why this person has came into your life. Trust the process, like I said. And if it's you, the one that kind of ran away from this connection, do not be surprised if in the month of August, it almost feels like the universe continuously keep pushing you towards this person. It could be that you bump into them on multiple occasions, and it's like you start to see synchronicities. You start to acknowledge that there is a higher purpose and a higher reason for this connection. Whether it was you or them that kind of, you know, went your own separate ways or pulled away from this connection out of fear. For some, it could be you, or it could be the person you're dealing with. But I definitely do see things continuing and evolving in the month of August all the way to September. All right, my lovelies, I hope that this gives you some type of guidance, understanding, wisdom, and knowledge, and we'll see each other soon. Bye.